sunscreen does a lot more than that. But their skincare, I feel like, is just, I don't find a point with it. I don't really have to tell you, I don't associate with the brand. I don't like the brand in general. Hi you guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're on my channel, I'm Akanksha. So in today's video, you read the title already, we are going to talk about sunscreens, everything about sunscreens, because it's all the hype everywhere. I see like 10 sunscreen ads every day. I have brands asking me for sunscreens. In the last like 2 weeks, I had like 4 or 5. Everybody wants to push sunscreen now only, although you are supposed to wear sunscreen throughout the entire year and every day. And now is the hype. So I'm going to talk about it. I'm going to debunk all the questions and the myths about sunscreens. And also, this is the second time I'm filming this video. The last one I filmed, the audio was so off because of this new microphone that I'm trying. So hopefully this one is better. And this was supposed to go up like last week. That's the reason it got delayed as well. But anyways, we're going to talk about sunscreen. I'm going to tell you what I prefer, what sunscreen means, and which sunscreens I like, which I don't, and which are probably like the worst ones to use. So let's get started. So let's start off with what a sunscreen is. A sunscreen is something which protects your skin from the sun. It not only just protects tanning, which people generally, the only reason people use for in India is like, oh, I don't want to get tan from the sun, so I'm going to use sunscreen. Sunscreen does a lot more than that. It prevents your skin from skin cancer as well, and also prevents your skin from aging as well. Let's get to the basic, where you get like SPF 50, SPF 30, 40. What to use, Akanksha? So SPF 30 or 40, the number of the SPF means the amount of UVB protection. Now, minimum SPF 30 is needed. 50 is preferable, especially harsh sun we have right now. And the PA++, your pluses signs determine the UVA protection of your sunscreen. So you need to have both. You need to have a UVB and a UVA protection to completely protect your skin from the sun. Now, people do argue that, oh, we get vitamin D from the sun. The benefits of that are much lesser compared to the cons of not using a sunscreen. I would always suggest you know, use a good sunscreen and try to avoid the sun as much as you can. That being said, now there are different filters of sunscreen, right? Like now when you wear a sunscreen, what is that thing which is going to protect your skin from the sun? There are sun filters which help remove that radiation of UVA and UVB from our skin, and there are two different types of it. One is a chemical filter and one is a physical filter. Chemical, also known as organic, physical is also known as mineral sunscreens. Now, I'm not a big fan of chemical sunscreens, especially the traditional chemical sunscreens. Now, I've made a video on sunscreens which I really like, which are physical. I will leave a link right here. The mineral sunscreens I like, which I've done like a year or two ago, which I still remain my favorite. But I'm not a chemical sunscreen, especially the traditional older one, because few of them are literally banned in few countries, you guys. I'll put a list of the sunscreens which don't work for me here, because honestly, I cannot pronounce it. Even if I try it, it'll just look like I'm literally unserious about this. These are very, very outdated. They never worked for my skin specifically. Whenever I used these ingredients, they made me break out. They give me an allergic reaction. Oxybenzone, avobenzone, these are all very UV unstable. They cause sensitivities to the skin. They enter our bloodstream. Most of them always made me break out. So I'm always on a hunt for sunscreens which are good, lightweight, may absorb pretty well, don't make me break out. 95% of the sunscreens on the market do not work for me. And if you have sensitive acne prone skin as well, I don't think they would work for you as well. And every time you wear a sunscreen, if you feel like you're breaking out, it is because of the filters which are there in the sunscreen. So these ones are not something I like. Although there are a new generation, like, you know, Korean skin or Korean beauty has come out with new generation sunscreen filters which don't get absorbed into your bloodstream as well. And those are actually pretty safe for my skin, and I've used those things. I'll put a list of those sunscreens which you might want to look for in your sunscreen if you're going and preference is a chemical sunscreen, which is like a Tinosorb S, Univel. I told you I cannot pronounce it. But these are new generation sunscreen filters which don't enter your bloodstream, which don't cause allergic reactions, which are very UV stable as well. But mostly in our market, we get the traditional or the older sunscreens as well only. And in US, FDA approved products are the main like thing, right? And FDA still only approves the old generational sunscreen filters and it does not approve the new ones. So traditionally, only those are still available for us. Although a lot of our Indian brands have started using the new generation filters, which I'm really glad. So that because now I at least have options to explore and, you know, see what works for my skin. Now, that being said about chemical, we have the physical filters, the mineral filters, which is generally titanium dioxide and zinc oxide. Now, zinc is extremely UV stable. It is anti-inflammatory. So it's great, especially if you have acne prone and anything. And they give you a great UVA and UVB protection as well. But the biggest con with mineral sunscreen is that they usually leave a pretty big or like a strong white cast. So I've tried to like narrow down a lot of things, try a lot of different sunscreens, and again I made a video with ones which give you the least amount of white cast. You check that out. I have a few recommendations for now, which new ones which I found at well, which we will be talking about. So this chemical ones generally never work for my skin. I would not even recommend them because most of them are not pregnancy safe as well. Not that I'm pregnant or anything, or but I don't want anything to be entering my bloodstream, you know. Avobenzone or octinosate filter is literally banned in Hawaii because they are not coral friendly as well. When you get into the water, the sunscreen wipes off and goes in the water and it harms coral life as well. So these sunscreen filters just don't cut it for me and they've never been really good. So I always prefer mineral sunscreen. So now that I gave you a gist of what different type of sunscreens can be, what my preference is, I'm going to talk about what products which are right now fully hyped in the market, which you can buy or not buy. So I went on to Nykaa and I typed sunscreen and these are the top ones which have come. So I'm going to review that. So the first one which I have is the Neutrogena Ultra Sheer SPF 50 PA +++. This one, I would just say kick it out. Like, just don't use it. Just leave it. I don't know why there people are still buying it. It's still available because this one has oxybenzone as a filter, which is one of the most, I feel like, allergic. And I think this is, if I'm not wrong, oxybenzone is banned in the UK. I'm not sure. I will check and let me just check it right now.
10 seconds later.
So oxybenzone as a sunscreen ingredient is currently under scrutiny by scientific community due to controversies about its environmental impact. It is banned in Hawaii, Palau and Thailand. Okay, oxybenzone I would not just like recommend anyways. It always made me break out. Every time it's there in a sunscreen, it just gave me an allergic reaction, got me tiny bumps, gave me really bad acne, which I don't like. So it has an oxybenzone, so just delete it from your life. Next one we have is the Lakme Sun Expert. Now Lakme, when I went to the website also to check the products, there is no list of ingredients. When there's no list, full entire ingredient list, it's the biggest red flag for me. I love like a lot of makeup products from Lakme, but their skincare I feel like is just I don't find a point with it. The only reason I feel like it's working because these are countertop, like available on like in stores. So people just go see and buy it. If you don't have a knowledge about it, they seem pretty fine. So I feel like that's how they make their majority of the sale. Next, we have the Dermaco 1% Sunscreen Aqua Gel with SPF 50. Now this one is something it has chemical filters only. It has ethyl hexyl methoxycinamide and it has butyl methoxy dye. Benzoyl methane. Now that's another term for avobenzone only, and the ethyl hexyl one is another term for octinosate. Now these are again chemical filters, a traditional one, which I would not recommend because they enter bloodstream and everything. But this sunscreen in specific, I've tried and it does not make me break out. It is actually, the consistency is pretty nice. I like how it's applied, but I would again not prefer it because it has those old generational sunscreen filters, which I would not recommend again. But if I have to pick one in all the right ones, this one is actually a pretty decent one. It has nothing comedogenic, it has no fragrance and nothing. So the next one we have is the Plum Cica and Hyaluronic Acid Aqua Light SPF 50 PA++++, non-oily, non-sticky, whatever. Okay, this one I was super excited to try, okay, because this one has new generational UV filters, which I was super excited for. Again, they have something which suits my skin, but the only problem, although it's the last third or fourth ingredient, it has coconut oil in it, and if you know, like, if you have acne prone skin and oily skin, you just stay like 100 kilometers away from coconut oil because it's extremely comedogenic. So maybe if you have really dry skin, you can try this one, but if you have oily and acne prone skin, I would not suggest. I really wish they supplemented coconut oil with something else, because if I'm seeing coconut oil, I'm not using that because I have acne and I don't want to trigger my skin. But this have new filters, which I'm super sad for because I can't try it. Next one we have is the Earth Rhythm Ultra Defense Hybrid Sun Fluid. Now this one is a one I really like. It has all new generational chemical filters which suit my skin. I've been using this one for a while now and it works really well for me. Next one we have is the Vishcare Invisible Gel Sunscreen. So this one seems nice that it's invisible and all, but again, this one also has Octocrylene, which is a traditional sunscreen filter, which this one again makes me break out so badly as an ingredient. This one does have new generational filters too. It has Tinosorb M and Tinosorb S, but I don't like it has Octocrylene. Now I have not tried this one yet, but it's just from like the ingredient standpoint that I judge a product that if I have to buy or not. I would not buy anything without looking at an ingredient list, especially after knowing so much about it. I always go in for it. And this one also has sunflower oil. Sunflower oil is not that comedogenic, but it has coconut butter, shea butter, cocoa butter, which again are very comedogenic. So it says invisible sunscreen, but once I apply, I get acne. That marks are not going to be invisible. So bye. Next, you have the Aqualogica Glow Plus Dewy Sunscreen. Now, this one again, I've been seeing ads left, right, and center. If you see the ingredient list without any bias to chemical filters, then the ingredient list is pretty nice. There's nothing comedogenic. It could be a great sunscreen. But again, it has Suncat DA, which is basically all the traditional sunscreen filters. It has ethyl hexyl methoxycinamide. It has avobenzone. So I would again not suggest this one because, like I said, not very keen. Now, if you are somebody who is into chemical, you want that lightweight finish, you want your sunscreen, you would not mind, you know, using these ones, then this and the Dermaco one are pretty good, but I would still not suggest it. Then Dr. Shade Ceramide and Vitamin C Sunscreen. This one again has chemical filters, which I don't like, so I would not recommend. But they have a mineral sunscreen, which I really like. It has great ingredient. It suits my skin really well. It gives the least amount of white cast. After 5 minutes, you can't really tell. And it is so water resistant, you guys. That one is so good, especially if you're going to a beach, you're going to water. You can see like when water touches your skin, it kind of creates a film that one sits so well on the screen. Initially, when they released the mineral sunscreen, it was very bad. They had that extreme white cast, but they did reformulate it and release a new mineral sunscreen, which is a great one to have actually, and I really like it. That one has zinc oxide as its main UV filter, so you can check that one out. The next one I have is a Dot & Key Watermelon and Hyaluronic Sunscreen. Now this one, Dot & Key as a brand, I really love. I love a lot of their products. They come out with very nice innovative ones, so I trust the brand to actually come out with new generational UV filter sunscreens as well, because this one, oh my god, I don't blame you if you like this one, because the texture consistency is so nice of the sunscreen. It just quickly gets absorbed. It does not feel like anything, but I would not recommend this. It does have chemical filters, but that point aside, that is so there that I don't recommend it. But although this one does not make me break out though, which I really like, I just feel like this one is not water resistant at all, and I feel like it doesn't protect my skin that well. If I go into water, it just like washes away. It just does not stay put, although it says that it is water resistant. So I feel like it doesn't do much, although it says it's SPF 50 and PA++. I've worn the Dr. Shade sunscreen, and I've worn the Dot & Key sunscreens different times on vacations, and I know the tan difference it makes. Like, directly, instantly, if I can tell if a sunscreen is working or not, is I feel like with my tan, and I know that how much the Dr. Shade one works, and compared to that, I feel like the Dot & Key one does not do much for me. So that's the reason I would not suggest this one. Next, we have the Minimalist SPF 50 PA++ sunscreen with multivitamin. This one I would not recommend because again it has octocrylin, which is a traditional one, but they have another one which is a SPF 60 PA++++, which is with antioxidant for sensitive, acne prone and like pregnancy safe. This one has new generational filter. It has Tinosorb S, Uvinal A+, Uvinal T150 and titanium dioxide. I've tried this one. It is a little heavy, but it is a great sunscreen. It has the new UV filters and nothing extremely comedogenic, and has SPF 60. It has like full spectrum protection, so you can check that one out, but not the other SPF 50 one. Okay, next. Oh my god, this is a Sun Scoop hydrating face and body fluid sunscreen spray. I don't know why this sunscreen has so many, of course it has all the filters and everything, but oh my god, it has so many oils, you guys. Especially if you want to go in sun, you need such UV stable ingredients, and this one has citrus peel oil, this oil. They have another sunscreen which has literally so many oils in it, which I feel like is extremely comedogenic as well. So I would not suggest Sun Scoop sunscreens at all, especially if you have acne prone skin. It's so difficult to find sunscreen. I just react to sunscreen so at least there are so many sunscreens which made me break out like crazy. Like, I instantly, like, if I apply now, by like in 6-7 hours I'll get like 6-7 tiny bumps, 2-3 pimples. It's that bad with me for my skin. Next, Mama Earth. I don't really have to tell you, I don't associate with the brand. I don't like the brand in general. They promote it as vitamin C, but it does not have any vitamin C in it. They're very like, I don't know how to put it, but I just don't like it. Again, this one is something I don't like it, wouldn't recommend as well. But yeah, those are the top ones I could see on Nykaa. So I hope they are useful for you guys. And if you want to see again recommendations, click right here. I will leave the link of the products in the description as well. If you want to shop of the ones which I really like, you can check it out. But yeah, I hope this video is useful, you guys. I wanted to keep it as simple as possible. So, and I did not want to like get very much in detail with like ingredients and everything, but I tried to keep it as simple and explain as much as I can. So I hope you guys, you know, enjoyed and learned something out of this and can pick the right sunscreen for yourself right now. And yeah, that's about it for this video. I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.